Something's troubling me.
Let's hear it.
What the bloody...
Geralt of Rivia, the King of the Witchers, the Witcher of Kings.
Come on, have a drink with us.
You'll get a chance to show your mettle. If we're to capture Foltest's murderer, we'll have to clash with the Squirtle.
I sent the boys out into the woods. Tough going, too dense. My scouts got ambushed and barely escaped.
It's no picnic hunting elves in the forest. Tell me something I don't know.
My people saw the Kingslayer again. He knows we're here, but he's not even trying to escape. Seems he's waiting for something.
I think it's our move. So, Forge.
Trouble.
What?
I wouldn't mind a shot. Celebrating something?
A great victory.
Interesting.
We did away with Veopatis, or whatever the hell they call him.
13 hacked off his head and nailed it to his arse.
You behaved like swine.
What? We're not allowed a bit of fun. It was only a wooden puppet.
Come on, let's play our game.
Right, toothpicks.
Knife throwing. Care to try me?
Gladly.
Vess against the Witcher. Place your bets, gentlemen. 10-1 on Vess. Witcher, map on the wall.
Vess, barrel!
Witcher, cured hand.
Vess, fish head!
Witcher, oar on the wall. Geralt wins.
There they are! Those are the shitheads who desecrated Veopatis' statue.
Pitchforks! Which will you say, bumpkin?
What's going on?
Nothing. We had a little competition.
They threw knives at a statue of Veopatis. It's blasphemy! Our gods desecrated by soldiers.
They're no ordinary soldiers, but blue stripes. Know what that means?
Blue or green, it's all the same to me. They're Horsans, all of them.
What did you say?
I just...
You said what you thought. Good, that's the way. Beer for this brave man. And drink to my health. Here's to the whore's son, Vernon Roach.
Vernon?
You've got shitty glassware in Flotsam. Not fit for a hero, but I've got an idea. Ah! Drink the Horson's beer from the floor!
Geralt, do something!
I'll try. Vernon! Leave him alone. It's not worth it.
You don't know shit. Consider this your lucky day, mongrels, and get out of here. I have to take a walk.
You're too hard on Roach.
I don't like sadists.
Vernon was a half-orphan.
What does that have to do with it?
He was raised in poverty. His mother turned to whoring to keep them from starving. The other children called him a whore's son. Hasn't been able to handle that insult since. Come on, let's have a drink.
All right.
Remember when we had to wait in the cave for reinforcements?
How could I forget? We ate peat, we were so starved.
Those were the days.
Here's to peat, tart and nutritious. Hey!
What do you say to a little competition? A keg of beer to whoever beats Geralt at arm wrestling.
And if Geralt wins?
I'll give you my sword. A true antique, but it sacks off many a head. You don't make them like this anymore.
All right.
Me throat's a little dry. Pour us a drink, someone. Remember when our better lieutenant I could plough 4 elven halls at once?
He said we'd sooner cross the sea on the arses of 4 whores strapped together to make a raft.
I'd have managed it.
Sure. If only there were that many elf women at the brothel. Let's begin. We'll see if 13 can beat the Witcher. Thirteen proves too weak for the Witcher. Keep practicing there, mate.
Plough off, the lot of you. Somebody pour me a drink. Remember when I rode my horse into a tree?
I'll say I do.
Have a shot. It'll refresh your memory.
Gentlemen, now it's Fenn against the Witcher. The prize is yours.
May it serve you well.
Gentlemen, to our health. Just like after the Battle of Gage.
Aye, that was a right piss up. We puked all over the battlefield.
To paradise on whore's asses.
Got drunk as newts, you did. Never seen anything like it in my life.
Anything like what?
Such a sight.
Meaning?
Better you don't remember.
But I want to know.
I tell you for a few odd ends.
Listen, I'm a witcher and I'm massively hungover right now. So speak or regret it.
All right, then. Talk to the madame. She knows the details.
Boss, why the hell are we stacking and restacking this stuff at the port still?
I think the stew's ready.
Quiet, woman. Artist at work.
You might want to stir it.
I don't step.
Something's troubling me.
Let's hear it.
Doing it Witcher and Striggard style.
No, tell me.
He downed the flat, tried to get it on, falls fast asleep, and she rings the virgin in the morning.
Greetings.
What can I get you, fine lad?
They say you know what happened here yesterday.
I do. But you'd be better off not asking, darling.
Talk.
Nothing's for free. Especially in a brothel.
All right. Talk.
Five of you came in. Or crawled in, I should say.
I was crawling?
Indeed. One of the blue ones ordered five girls. I gave you the best because you showed me good coin.
What happened next?
This is the interesting bit, because instead of ploughing them like the normal soldiery, you mounted them and told them to give you a ride to the port.
Can't be.
Ask the lass in the uniform, then.
Vess was here too?
Sure was. She tried to stop you, but you were too much for her. Remind me,
Which one was this Foltest they killed?
I talked to the madam. Is what she says true?
I tried to talk you out of it, but you insisted you cross the river on the whore's arses. You tried for several hours, but it just wasn't going to be.
What happened next?
You said you wanted to be one of the blue stripes and had to get yourself a tattoo.
What tattoo?
One like ours. And you got it.
Shit. Where are my things?
You left them all over the place. I gathered them in that trunk by the window.
Thanks, Vess.
Watch out for Fenn. He's downright daft, that one.
How did you end up in the blue stripes?
Why do you ask?
Well, you're a beautiful girl and...
So what? I'm not a nobleman's or merchant's daughter. All right. I may have the looks, but with my background, the best I could hope for was to be a maid in some roadside inn, or to work at a brothel not unlike the local one, using my sweet lips to give blowjobs for a handful of coppers. So I'll stick to slitting elven throats, thank you.
Definitely the better choice if you look at it that way. They say you're good at it.
Right you are.
I have trust issues. I like to know who's covering my ass.
No need to worry, Witcher. I'm good at what I do.
Do I see a sensitive little girl hiding behind a mask of indifference?
I wouldn't be here if you were right. I was raised in a small village where people cared about two things only. If the drought was going to destroy their crops, and if the Scoia'tael would appear in the local woods. One day, a large Scoia'tael unit appeared. They burned the village to the ground and slaughtered all the inhabitants. I alone survived because their commander, the bastard, fancied me. They dragged me around with them for months. I knew they'd kill me once they tired of me. And then Vernon turned up.
Did he draft you into service?
He taught me everything I know. In time, I realized my place was with the Blue Stripes. I'm a soldier because I do it well.
Ever dreamed of a different life?
Finch, our marksman, once tried farming, but he just didn't have the hands for it.
Bet he'd get me right between the eyes from 80 paces off.
100. I've tried cooking, darning, smiling like a doll, serving beer in a tavern. None of my thing.
You know what you want, and I like that.
You're quick to pounce, Witcher. Except you've got the wrong girl.
You think so?
All right. Roach has decided you're sailing with us. Fine. But it wouldn't be the best time even if I fancied you, which I don't. I need your sword, not your dick. Anyway, as far as I know, you're hardly indifferent to Triss Merigold.
Does that bother you?
I don't care. But I'm not about to mess with a sorceress.
Nice area, isn't it?
I prefer these little towns, forgotten by gods and people alike, to palaces and castles. It's survival of the fittest here. At least you know what to expect. So yes, I like it here.
Is your hatred towards the Scoia'tael some sort of revenge?
You don't know me, Geralt. Human or non-human, it makes no difference to me. We were chosen to fight the Scoia'tael, and that's the mission we pursue. To me, the Scoia'tael are but bandits hiding out in the woods. If there were humans among them, I'd kill them in a flash just the same.
The man we're looking for is much more dangerous than any Scoia'tael.
Must be, if he managed to outwit Geralt of Rivia.
It wasn't the first time someone tried to kill Foltest. I killed an assassin before. That means there could be more assassins out there.
If anyone screws up, it won't be me, I assure you.
Greetings! Your pubes white too?
Listen, you know how to remove a tattoo?
I thought you looked different. Couldn't put my finger on it though.
Think it looks all right?
What's it of? A naked lady brandishing a sword? Geralt.
All right, you can stop now.
Hey, I didn't give you that tattoo. There's this mixture that cleanses the tissue just beneath your skin. To make it, I'll need green mold, white myrtle petals, and wolf's aloe.
Well, I'm off to hunt down some herbs. I'd appreciate it if you didn't mention this to Dandelion. And you can stop laughing.
No, I can't. become winters too? Hey, handsome.
Any progress?
I never expected to see you at Laredo's.
Whereas I was sure you would show up there. The Commandant is terribly jealous about his small trading post. Anyone of import is summoned to hear him out sooner rather than later.
What did he want from you?
That is my concern, certainly none of yours. We're not a tandem, Geralt. We'll kill the Kayran together, but that is all.
Did you find out where the Kayran came from?
I didn't even try.
So I take it you know it was created by a mage.
I guessed as much. And what of it? Do you wish me to feel guilty, apologize for some madman? I don't intend to. How did you know it was a mage?
I didn't. Just guessed. Triss claims the Kayran was born of magic.
She's right. Something that large couldn't possibly evolve in the waters of the Pontar. It looks like the result of some botched experiment. It's growing rapidly and will probably age just as quickly.
I've got everything I need. Let's go.
Excellent. Ready?
Are you wearing makeup?
We all have our rituals.
From what I know, Kayrans are colorblind.
Enough, Geralt. Time to draw the beast out of the water.
Got an ace up your sleeve?
I always do. Don't get eaten, and we'll soon both be heroes.
I hope you're right.
You descend into the lair. I'll stay on the bridge and pull it out onto the bank. Take care. It'll be extremely dangerous, even on land.
did it. Not a bad fight, wouldn't you say, Geralt? Are you all right?
The beast got me a couple of times.
I've heard you've been in more dire situations. I wonder, are the stories about you true?
What stories?
If you think I'm going to repeat some of the legends circulating about you, you're deeply mistaken.
What now?
I must harvest the most valuable ingredients while the corpse is fresh. I'd prefer to get the entire carcass to my laboratory and strip it down to the bone, but that would be a waste of power and simply too much work. I shall take only...
What have you heard about me?
A number of things.
You won't talk about them?
I've no time now. The fresher the ingredients I collect, the higher the price I'll get. Sorry.
Farewell, then.
Don't forget to collect the reward.
Oh, I won't.
We'd best get to work.
Any idea what Yorvith intends towards Lurita or the local humans?
Only he knows that. But I suspect he's at a loss, unsure what to do. He's in the area, mounts the occasional ambush, then lies low for a few days. But he's yet to put together a larger attack.
I think he's waiting for the Commandant to lower his guard.
It would appear so. But Yorveth is famous for his viciousness. He's fought regular troops, attacked much larger settlements. Delaying the fight this long is unlike him. Unless there's something I don't know about. Good luck. Thank you.
we're not here.
Something's troubling me.
Let's see.
A fine mess you have here. Dwarves stealing bread from the mouths of honest craftsmen. Elves wandering among decent folk.
The Commandant will deal with them just as soon as he's dealt with the Scoia'tael.
Lerido, catch Yorveth. The sky will sooner rain anchovies.
Don't badmouth the Commandant. He's a decent man and a patriot.
I don't deny that, but he could perform his patriotic duties more vigorously.
Bloody grubs, I hope they rot in hell.
Job done. The Cairn's dead.
Good work. You've earned your reward.
Hello, Geralt!
You might want to stir it.
I don't stir. I work the material.
Well, well. How's the Commandant as a host?
It's people like him who might help us.
Or put us in shackles and throw us into the river.
He told me they're keeping Scoia'tael prisoners on a barge in the port.
Did he mention if Kirin Ep Esnilin, Yorveth's right-hand elf, is among them?
No.
He may know something about the Kingslayer.
Let's pay him a visit.
Boss, so what about that bonus?
Is the work complete?
What do you want?
To speak with the wounded prisoner.
No one's allowed.
I'm here on Commandant Lerido's orders.
I already cut a deal with you, but...
So get out of my way.
He won't tell you much. He's dying.
I don't know what I'm talking about now.
Shut your traps. Stop bloody moaning down there.
Look, Coffer's dozed off.
Wakey, wakey, Coffer. You'll fall asleep forever any day now. Look, Birdie's all wet. Hey, Birdie, you get wet just looking at me.
Get ready, Birdie. We'll be down to see you right after our watch. Welcome.
Be vigilant.
They beat him bad. He's got at least a dozen fractures. I'll need your help.
What do I do?
The spell I'm going to use is painful. It could kill him if he thrashes around.
I'll use the Axie sign to calm him.
Perfect.
You wish, Horsen. I'm no traitor.
He's raving.
Vatgun? Where am I?
In Flotsam, on the prison barge.
The convict's barge? I'm done for.
How did Lerido's goons catch Yorveth's right-hand elf?
I was betrayed. How else?
You'd be dying in pain if it wasn't for us.
If it wasn't for the Dwarn, I wouldn't be here.
There's a Witcher in Yorveth's unit.
Like every Dwarn, he turned out to be a bastard.
What happened?
He betrayed us. He said he had an offer for me. So we met, where roses of remembrance grow. I should have known.
Roses of remembrance?
Yes, some of the last in the world. He thought that I'd betray my elven brother in order to control the unit. I refused. And there was a fight. I've never seen anything like it. No human can move that fast. It was a massacre. I was the first to be hit. Thus I survived. I would have bled to death had Laredo's men not found me. Letho will kill Yorveth, and all will be lost. So many dead. So much suffering. All for naught.
Letho, he's the Kingslayer?
Yes.
Why does the Dwan want Yorveth dead?
He used us. From the start. Our hatred. But he no longer needs Yorveth. Sees him as a thorn in his side. I don't know what Letho wants.
What does Yorveth want? Why Flotsam?
Go plow yourself.
You have to tell me. I'm on your side.
If you say so. Flotsam is only the beginning. We're no bandits, we fight for freedom. In due time, Yorveth will answer the call, and we'll emerge from the woods, joining the battle.
What battle?
He wasn't specific.
In that case, I'll ask Yorveth himself.
I'd like to see that.
We got what we came for.
What now?
Yorveth.
What if Yorveth already knows?
I've got an old saying all ready for him. My enemy's enemy is my friend.
Warn him, Gwynplaine. Yorveth fights, for that is what he does best. He's Enshay, a real one, a free one. Among the last. Fighting makes sense, now more than ever before. There is still hope.
What are you talking about, Kieran? Hope for what?
For change. For a better tomorrow. I'll not see it. They'll torment me to death on this barge, and I'll go gladly where the apple trees bloom. But you must warn Yorveth.
Yennefer told me that Ciri has departed for good. She inhabits another world and is happy there. Before she left this one, she gave us the Isle of Avaloch, our island. We stopped counting time. People believe that the wraiths of the Wild Hunt are immortal. They race across the heavens, gripping in their bony hands swords, their lightning bolts. They take away mortals, ever expanding their cavalcade of spectral riders. They burned the orchard and the house. In their armored boots, they trampled our island. And then made off with Yennefer. I had to get her back. Return to reality. Return to the Witcher's path.
Geralt, are you all right?
I've been to the Isle of Avaloch, among the apple trees and the mists. After the massacre in Rivia, Ciri took me there, and Yennefer. The Wraith Riders kidnapped Yen, and I pursued them.
But...
Triss, this is important. I feel like everything's coming together. When the Witchers found me barely alive a half year ago near Kaer Morhen, I was fleeing the Wraiths of the Hunt. They continued to pursue me. In the outskirts. Then in Vizima, when I killed the Grand Master. Now I know it was no coincidence.
Kieran mentioned roses of remembrance growing somewhere near here. Cedric claims likewise. If that's true...
Right now I should be searching the forest for Yorveth, not looking for flowers.
I could restore your memory.
You sure?
Everything seems to indicate that. Whatever's blocking your memory is clearly weakening. I think I could break that barrier with just one petal from a rose of remembrance. Those flowers are truly powerful.
In that case, Yorveth can wait.
Want me to go with you?
I'll take care of this on my own. Wait for me in town.
I want to help.
I'll manage.
Uh-huh.
This won't take long. I'll ask some locals about the Elven ruins, find the rose, and I'll be back.
I'll be waiting.
Shut your traps! Stop bloody moaning down there!
Look, Coffer's dozed off.
Wakey, wakey, Coffer. You'll fall asleep forever.
What's in these crates, boss?
King Vridank's treasures.
And in those?
The amber.
Ah,
You free?
No, working my arse off like a stagecoach.
Looking for a rose of remembrance. Know where I can find or buy one?
Not your lucky day, Wanderer. Sold my last one, oh, 3 winters ago, must be. But earnestly, I received one a few years back from a huntsman who sought to make me his woman. He found it deep in the forest, where practically no one dares venture.
Even you?
Fate needs no tempting. The huntsman's long since dead, and he was a large, strong man who knew the forest well. I'm in no hurry to see the beyond.
Any idea who could tell me more?
Well, no one knows the wood better than Cedric.
Well, I'll be...
I need a rose of remembrance. Can you help?
You speak of Eldon and Cymeral's bloom. Yes, Gwynblade, I know where they grow.
Where might that be?
In the Garden of the Eternal Lovers.
Where's that?
It's no place for humans. Lorido pays some rats to bring him sculptures from the garden.
I'm not working for Lorido.
Got a drink? Vodka would be best.
Cedric.
I must have a drink. The specters approach to torment me with their visions. I can feel it. Do you have any vodka?
Here.
Ah, thank you. The forest has been calmer since you killed the Cairn, you know.
Glad to hear it. Now focus, Cedric. Roses of remembrance. Where can I find some?
Proceed south through the forest, all the way to the lake. Beware of the Endrigers and Neckers, and the traps that I've set. Nearby, on a plateau, you'll find the Garden of Eldon and Cymeril.
Liquor will kill you, Cedric. You should drink less.
I prefer this fog to madness. Wouldn't you?
At your service.
Go. Cedric mentioned there are some old elven buildings near the cascade in the forest. We should start there.
Lead the way.
Thank you.
think the stew's ready.
Don't tell him. Why are you taking your pants?
Artist at work.
Don't try anything.
You might want to stir it.
End your life.
I don't stir, say. I work.
Girls, we come with just two.
I think we've arrived. The cascade, the menhir. We need to take the path leading upwards.
Gardens in the middle of forests? Those elves really like to complicate things.
Stop whining. It's not far now. Cedric told me a beautiful legend about this place.
Legends are almost always beautiful, especially elven ones. The reality often leaves a lot to be desired.
Well, Cedric also said the sight itself was something wonderful. The rose must be here somewhere.
I'll look around.
Alden and Cymoril. Cedric said Cymoril eclipsed even Francesca Findebear with her beauty, and Francesca's reputed to be the world's most beautiful woman.
Cedric drinks too much.
He really has visions, you know. He really has the gift. He could learn to control it if he drank less.
Cedric drinks to get rid of the visions, and that's something I understand perfectly well.
My lovers, look up. It's beautiful. I just don't understand it. How did the elves become so cruel? The one with the scar had so much hatred in him.
Places like this make you realize just how much they've lost. There used to be entire elven cities, and the forests were theirs to enjoy, not to hide in. Humans destroyed that, put them in reservations. Yorvith and his kind are taking revenge. Though not all elves are like that.
Kieran said there's a lot more at stake.
He has his ideal, a certain vision of the world. But do you think there's room for humans in it?
We're practically one and the same.
Wrong, Triss. We've been learning from each other for generations, but we're different at base.
I don't know why I find that awfully sad.
Just like this garden. Beautiful and sad.
Cymoril's Rose of Remembrance. Legend has it they wilt unless nourished with blood, and also if they're sold. But give it to someone you love, and it'll live forever.
This one's for you.
Oh, Geralt.
I want you to keep it. If there's any truth to the legend, it shouldn't wilt, even if you pluck a petal or two.
Thank you.
This is the statue, Curly. Don't mind us. Imagine the corn we'll get. I won't leave the brothel for a month.
6 weeks, even.
Where does that woman get the gold for all this? I mean, her and the old man, they're buying a new house. And now these statues for the garden. Must be defrauding the treasury. What's a town chancellor do anyway?
It'd be ploughing hard to move.
We'd never shift it in one piece. I know. We'll break off the legs, the heads, remove it in bits.
Break off your own head, clown.
Shut your trap, cunt.
And...
Kill them!
Hit the freeze!
Watch out!
What the end shape built before human ships ever appeared in the Pontar Delta. Elves possess a sensitivity humans can't ever hope to acquire. We're trapped. Looks like we're stuck. There must be another way out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you looking at me that way? Do I have something on my face?
Uh-uh.
What's going on in that head of yours, Witcher?
Oh, you know. Stuff. You could use a bath.
So could you.
A witcher's blade. Letho comes here to think.
Well, he's not here now, so we've no reason to stay.
The Dwan stole the story of Eldon and Cymoril. But they now steal our roses of remembrance. A more silly and shallow tale I've never heard. An enchanted wood, a beautiful elven couple living within. A handsome human prince arrives, riding a milk-white stallion. Bloody Dwan. We Enshe remember how it was. Limitless devotion, passion, commitment, and sacrifice. Legend has it the lovers' sighs are enchanted in these very stones, though only those in love can hear them.
Singing bushes, jabbering stones, elven hogwash. Buggers.